In Amazon, every seller's ultimate goal is to rank for relevant keywords. So whenever any buyer will search by those keywords, they can show their items in the first page. You can try right now by searching a keywords to find your products. And if it's showing, it's good. And if it's not showing, you must need to find out the reason why it's not showing. But even if it's showing now, you have to prepare a plan to keep that rank, because it's a very high competition right now on Amazon, and to keep that position is very hard. So you must prepare your plan to keep that position. And the only way you can do this by the help of the Amazon PPC campaigns. Because in campaigns, you can target specific keywords and you can control those keywords by your own. This is Saiful from Ecomclips. We are managing over hundreds of thousands ad spend monthly. And in today's video, I will show you how you can check your keyword performance effortlessly and easily. So right now we are one of our Seller Central account, and you can see we have spent nearly 1.6 million pounds of ad spend, and we got around 6.5 million pounds of sales with closely 24% ACoS. And you can understand now how many keywords we need to run to manage this amount of ad spends. Now if I show you last 30 days of data, now you can see we have spent 44k and we got 175k of sales with ACoS just about 25%, and our CPC is around 0.49%. And below you can see how many clicks we got. Like we got around 90k clicks. So you can realize how many keywords we need to run to get these amounts of clicks. And in last 30 days, our impression was 21 million. So right now I need to show you from where you can see those data. So you can go to this targeting tab, and this targeting tab will give you all the keywords in one place, like automatic campaigns, close match, lose match, and all the keywords you have targeted in your campaigns. All together you can see over this tab. So firstly, I would like to show you this graph. It's similarly to the dashboard graph. You can see the impressions, clicks, and you can add other metrics over here. And like you, mostly I would see the spend. So I can see spend, sales graph, or ACoS graph. So firstly, I would like to show you the graph. So you can see this graph is similar with the current dashboard graph, and you can check all the metrics over here. So for example, I want to see sale and spend graphs. So I can see the daily sales and spends from this graph. And here is a quick overview. They are showing like 16k targets are not delivering. So definitely I need to check into this. And here are some top performance, like based on I think impressions. Yeah, so these are the keywords giving me the highest impressions, and I can change like the click what will be my top performance keywords. So these are the keywords that are getting the highest clicks, and I can choose these three metrics like impressions, clicks, orders, and I can check the top performance and the bottom performance. Now here are the date range. It's almost similar as our regular dashboard. So I can see last 30 days data right now. And you can also do export here, so which is a good thing. And from here I can add different types of metrics, like, so here's one important metrics that I can add is the conversion rate, which is missing in our regular campaigns. Now you can see we have in total 22k targetings. In last 30 days we have spent around like 42k, and our ACoS was around 26%. So the first thing what I do whenever I get into this tab, I sort out by the ACoS. Like whenever I sort it out by highest ACoS, I can see in last 30 days which are the keywords were having highest ACoS, and I need to like adjust them properly. And by these date trends, you can also check last 7 days highest ACoS or specific days of performance for those keywords. Now you can see I have sort out the lowest to highest ACoS, and these are the keywords that are giving me very low ACoS, like 1, 2, 3, 4%, 5% of ACoS. So mainly we need to check which are the keywords giving me the highest ACoS, because they can kill my profit. So okay, I can see these are the keywords like 350% of ACoS, 280% of ACoS, 270% of ACoS. Like there are lots of keywords that are having more than 100% of ACoS. So definitely I need to make sure to adjust them properly. Like for here, I have targeted a category and they spend around £100 and only get £50 of sales. This is crazy. So after ACoS, what I see the highest spending keywords, because sometime we need to check the keywords that are spending the most. Is it relevant or not? Or the keywords I want to rank, are those keywords spending or not? So here I have sort out the highest spending keywords in all the campaigns. And right away I can see this close match. This is the auto campaign. So what I can see, mostly the auto campaigns are doing the highest spend, and there are some keywords that are spending. And now I can see these are the keywords they're spending highest, and their ACoS is also reasonable. Only these auto campaigns having over 30% ACoS, so definitely I need to check this out. After that, what I can check is the sales. So I will check which are the keywords giving me the highest sale. So yes, you can see here the keywords that are giving me highest sales. So again, it is the automatic campaigns, they are giving me the highest sales, and there are some keywords that are giving me some good amount of sales. So normally what I check from this overview, the keywords are giving me the highest sales, are they getting enough budgets or not? Like for example, I can show you here, this targeting have 11% of ACoS, but the budget is not enough. So I must need to increase the budget for this targeting so they can spend more and give me more sales, as the ACoS is very good. And from this view, if you check anything irrelevant and you want to adjust it, you just can go to this ad group. So you can just click on this and you will go to this ad group and you can directly adjust from there. So now you can like adjust the bids, or if you want to pause anything, you can just directly do right there. So now the amazing part of this tab is the filter option. So they have some gem, I would say, because I can filter out with some options that can give me a very good overview for my account. Like here, I will filter with ACoS over 30%, because for this account, if the ACoS is over 30%, it's a red sign. So right now I can see in last 30 days how many keywords are giving me high ACoS. So here you can see 600 keywords are giving me over 30% of ACoS, and they are spending 17k of my budget with just below 40k sales, and the ACoS is like over 43%. So in this way I can check which are the targeting I need to adjust more, so we can reduce the ACoS faster. And now another way is to find out the good keywords, like less than 30%. So these are the keywords that should be spending most of the budget, and we should focus on these keywords more. So right away you can see over 800 of keywords we have that giving me lower than 30% ACoS, and you can just see over there spending is 23k, we are getting over 110k sales, and the ACoS is under 20%. So I can tell you right away, if we can manage the keywords that have over 30% ACoS, we can definitely lower the ACoS more. Like we can lower the ACoS by 3 to 5% within a day. So now let me show you some other filtration options. So for example, here we can check the conversion rate. This is missing in our regular campaign. So for example, if I check, the conversion rate is over 3%. So right away you can see here we have over 1400 sub targeting that have over 3% of conversion rate. So if I saw we have around 20% of conversion rate most of our keywords, then I can decide if the keyword conversion rate is less than 5%, it's a red sign. So you need to find out the sweet spot for your account to find out the correct conversion rate that you are looking for. So here I can see still we have 600 sub keywords, they have over 20% of conversion rate and they are giving me over 77k of sales. So I would say if any keywords have less than 7% or 10% conversion rate for this account, then it's not a good keyword for this seller central account. So let me check which are the keywords they have less than 10% of conversion rate. And based on that conversion rate, I can adjust the keywords bidding or budgeting, or if I saw it's not relevant with my keywords, I can pause those keywords. So you can see over there over thousands of keywords we have, they have less than 10% of conversion rate. And you can see here, they spend over 9K, they got only just around 18K of sales, and look at their ACoS is almost 52%. So definitely this is a like wrong keywords or like red alert keywords for my account. So I would say Amazon should add these features in the regular campaign very soon. Now for the another way, like I can show you the sales is equal zero. What it will do, it will give you the keywords that didn't get any sales but they spent. So here you can see we have a lot, like 20,000 of keywords that didn't get any sales and they spent around 1.8k. so it's not a large amount, because in these accounts in last 30 days we spend around like 44k. So 1.8k is not that great amount. So I would say it's relatively low for this account. Now what I show you here, it's only the targeting, like you are targeting a keywords in broad match, phrase match, or in automatic campaigns, close match, loose match, or complement, substitute, those. But there's one lacking in this tab, and that's the search term. Because in automatic campaigns, you need to check the search term report to make sure the close match is working well. Also, in broad match and phrase match keywords, you need to check the search term report to get a clear idea. Now, as this tab is not giving me all those informations, now we need to download the search term report. Now, still, this tab is giving us a lot of data that can be used properly and take some quick decisions. And you can improve your ACoS significantly with a very low effort. So right now I will go to my sponsor products report and I will download the last 30 days of search term report. So here I have downloaded the last 30 days of search term report and I will do a filter here, and now you can see these are all the search terms. Like for these phrase match keywords, they have like three different sub search terms. Now that was missing in the targeting tab. Also for these keywords, I have lots of different search terms that was also missing in the targeting tab. And these are also a very valuable information that we need to make sure the keyword is working properly. Now here what I can show you, the more details, more deep data. So I am sorting out all the keywords that didn't get any sales in last 30 days, and you can see how much they spent. They spent around £10,000, which is very high right now if we compare with the total spend, because in total we spend around 44k, and right now what I can see, £10,000 we spent that didn't give us any sales. So definitely in targeting tab we didn't get the proper overview about the waste spend. Right now we can see the proper overview of the waste spend. Now all those keywords I would not say OST spend because there could be only one click. So let me sort out by the spend highest to lowest. So normally what we do, we set a range, like for example, here you can see, I would say if any keywords that have over like £4.5 of spend that didn't give us any sales, I would add the search term as a negative. And also another way I can do is by the based on the number of clicks. So I would say if after like 10 clicks or 15 clicks, if any keyword that didn't give us any sales, we can add them in the negative. So you can see over there, there are some keywords that we missed out when we sort by the sale, when we sort by the spendings. Now you can see these keywords have 16 clicks that didn't give us any sales, and it's in the exact match keywords. And also this is a keyword that get 15 clicks but didn't give us any sales. So these are the keywords, if you think they are not relevant and they will not convert, you can also add them in the negative keywords. And here is the quick tips for you to increase your CTR. Now you can see over there, they have a lots of keywords, they have very low CTR. So you can sort out like smallest to largest, and you can see why these keywords have a lowest CTR. Like on Amazon, lower than like 0.30% CTR is bad. So right away you can see these are the keywords or search terms, they are not giving you the proper CTR. So you can see if you want to run them, or you can pause them, or if you think it's not relevant to your keyword, then you can take any other decisions that can improve your CTR a lot. Now like CTR, you can also check the CVR for your search term, and then you can take decisions like which are the keywords that you want to push in your PPC campaigns. And whenever you want to rank for any keywords, Amazon will check a couple of things like the CTR, the conversion rate. These two things they will mainly focus to give your item a rank. So you must need to check these two metrics for your desired keywords that you want to rank in the first place. Nowadays, Amazon is getting more complicated day by day. And if you are not doing things properly, you can lose your keywords rank, your sales, your money, and you will never realize it. And due to these high competitions, it's very tough now in Amazon to keep the positions going. In Ecomclips, we are managing over hundreds of accounts, and we know how hard it is right now. So if you need any help, feel free to mail us at info@ecomclips.com. You can also check out our website www.ecomclips.com, where you will find useful blogs. And if you have any questions regarding this video, feel free to comment below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel Ecomclips. Let's grow together.